Hey, I'm here to do another trailer reaction. My computer's letting me do reactions at the moment. For a while, it was blocking me from doing it for some reason, but it's letting me do them again now, which is good because I've got quite a few to be catching up with. So, this is another retro trailer reaction, actually. It's Alien from 1979, Ridley Scott's Alien, a classic horror movie starring Sigourney Weaver. I was 10 years old when this came out, so I certainly didn't see it at the cinema. I don't remember seeing the trailers either. I was aware of the movie, but I can't remember. I think the first time I just had an idea, an inkling of what the movie was about, was when I saw, I'm sure I saw a Mad parody from like a Mad magazine during the day. I'm sure there was like a parody of it in a Mad magazine. It just rings a small bell in my brain. And then I'm sure it came onto BBC eventually. I don't know how long later it came onto the BBC, maybe 3 years later, maybe. I don't know. I feel like I was younger when I watched it though, to be honest. I'm sure I remember watching it around my mate's house and being scared to go downstairs to go to the toilet afterwards because it was a scary movie. But let's just crack on with it. Obviously, it's a classic. I watched it for years, actually, but it's we'll see how it holds up and how the trailer catches my interest. Space, the final frontier. It's very quiet. Does it need volume? Oh, yeah, it needs volume. That oh, it's from the word aliens that about to be formed. It's very cryptic, isn't it? Doesn't tell you anything. There you go. I'm remembering it now. I'm remembering the alien logo. Wow, this is so minimal, so minimalist. I'm blocking the A. I'm blocking the N. There it is. Alien. Wow. So far, I'm getting a vibe of when I did the Exorcist trailer reaction. It's really giving you very, very limited information about it. It's literally just very atmospheric space scene drawing away to that egg. It's an egg. You probably would have recognized it as an egg at the time. And it cracks open. You'll be like, what the hell's inside there? And then all you're getting is like kind of dark sort of spaceship scenes, people running away. You're not getting any dialogue. You're not getting any narration, even. It's a real kind of, I think this is probably from what I saw from the Exorcist trailer. They don't show everything nowadays. They show bloody everything. There's so many, maybe because there's so many films that are around that people want to try and hook people in, so they're showing them more and more stuff on trailers to get the interest up, to pique the interest more. But this one is kind of like piquing my interest by being less, because it's like, what the hell is going to happen here? What's going on? And obviously, I know now because it's 53 years ago, but I can imagine at the time it'd be like, wow, that looks interesting, without giving you any hints necessarily of what was going to happen. There's an alien. You can see people are worried. People are running away scared. There's a claustrophobic spaceship. And I think it's definitely these old, so far, these old horror trailers are winning me over compared to like the modern day ones. I did a reaction to a modern trailer the other day, and I'm pretty sure you saw the final scene. There was a bit where someone looked like had been killed, and I thought, that's the guy who was a protagonist. He was the evil guy. He's just been killed. You can see he's wearing the same clothes, something like that. And it was just like, well, it hardly seems worth going to see that film now because I know how the guy gets killed in the end. But this is just like completely mysterious and like deliberately obtuse, is that the correct word? It's not telling you. It's keeping it secret. It's an enigma. It's an alien enigma. I think there is a film called Alien Enigma, actually. Smithy, is it Smithy the cat, innit? Oh. Oh, wow. In space, no one can hear you scream. Oh, man, that is awesome. It doesn't even say it just lets you read it. That is a hell of a good trailer, man. That was an awesome trailer. Wow. makes me want to not know what happened so I can watch it all over again. It makes it kind of feel like you think, oh yeah, just give me a memory erasure so I can watch that film again and not know what's going to happen. That was interesting. That was exciting. That was such moody atmosphere, such horrible, bleak kind of music, discordant ambient noise rather than music, wasn't it? And it was just darkness, and then it seemed to be amping up the fear, what the hell was going on kind of thing, looking at all the little scenes flashing in front of you, like just literally little flashes of images, like, you know, and it kind of dialed it up towards the end. It really, like, it played it like an orchestra. You had a nice opening scenes where the music wasn't quite so discordant and it was showing you the atmosphere. It was still chilling, it's still sort of worrisome, still a hint of danger about it, still an air of dread. And then just literally just it just built itself up into a crescendo of noisy ambient kind of sounds and like images flashing before your eyes. The cat there, you had a semi-clad woman's bottom as well, which is always a treat, but not in that situation because it looked like there was someone who was scared to crap at what that was going on. But yeah, that was really cool. I enjoyed that trailer. No wonder it was a bloody hit. Even a bloody trailer, even that trailer's better than half the bloody movies you get nowadays, I think. And it's, yeah. And they didn't even bother with narration, literally just that title line, "In space, no one can hear you scream." Whoever came up with that probably helped with making money for that film, I've got to say, because just that tagline is just, it's a classic, isn't it? Just an absolute banging classic of a, whatever. I'm trying to think of any other sort of like taglines for movies that compare to it. Wasn't there one for Jaws? You'll be afraid to go in the water or near the water again. I can't remember now. But I'm sure, I can't think of any other film. There must be other films that have got like similar kind of iconic taglines like that. Can't think of any off the top of my head though, but there must be some. But there, that one, "In space, no one can hear you scream," absolutely bloody nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. And the whole trailer absolutely nailed it. It makes me, like I say, it makes me wish I hadn't seen it before so I could see it again. Apparently that was for the director's cut as well. It says here the director's cut is 1 hour 55. I'm not sure how much is different than the director's cut. But yeah, that was, just excellent pacing even for a trailer. You know, just the way it ramped up, way it started off with, I'm not going to bother mentioning it again, but literally you start off here, kind of this slightly disturbed, slightly worried, and then he just ramped it up to the end where it's like, oh, what's going on here? There's some nasty looking stuff going on. You got the bit where the white spray was coming out of Ian Holmes' character. Was he called Bishop, or was that the one from Aliens? But the alien, the robot guy, you had white bloody stuff coming out of him, and you just about saw that off screen. Didn't show you it properly. You saw a little bit, and you got a quick flash. Your cat ran off. You got a quick flash of the alien face huggers, like tendrils or something, just to give you a hint of the horror that the film's got inside. The horror the film contains, or whatever. I can't speak properly, but or think properly for that matter. But yeah, that was an awesome trailer. Actually, I can't remember the last time I saw the trailer, but that literally, I mean, I've seen the film, and you've got glimpses, because knowing the film, you've got glimpses, you knew where certain bits were within the film, but lots of it was just running down like dark passageways and just intense atmosphere. And you know, there was no kind of, there was a little bit of a shock scare when you saw the tendrils coming at you, which would have, I can just imagine you'd see that as a trailer when before the film come out, and you'd be like, bloody hell, what the hell is that? I must go and see that. that looks absolutely terrifying. And yeah, in its day, it certainly was. I remember, as a kid, it was bloody scary. But anyway, I think that's enough of my reaction to that trailer. A bloody awesome trailer, actually. As trailers go, I've got to give it a 10 out of 10 as a trailer. Not that I've been ranking the trailers or anything, but that's definitely, just looking at that, definitely one that if you're in any kind of horror or sci-fi, it's definitely one you'd have to go and watch just by seeing that trailer. That was an amazing job. Anyway, I am buggering off now. That's enough of me talking about this retro trailer. If you want to give me your reactions to my reaction, then by all means, leave us a comment down below, and give me a sub if you want to get some more reactions from me in the future. And most importantly, don't forget the old, ooh, thumbs up, because we all have a thumbs up now, don't we? Give me a thumbs up. Ooh, give me a thumbs up. Ooh, like a face hugger. Ooh, thumbs up. Yeah. And I'll be back in the future sometime with another trailer reaction. Cheers.